There we go. I think we're here. I think we're live now. I'm going to let some more folks join us and then we'll get this thing started. Usually, and for those of you watching, I'm Joshua Short from Channel 16. Hi. We thank you guys for tuning in. This is the 6th annual Black History Month Award ceremony for the city of South Bend. We're really happy you guys are here. We want some more people to join in. So if you can really quickly text your friends, your family members, your ex-boyfriends, your baby mamas, let them know what we're doing. This is going to be an awesome night. It's going to be filled with so much fun. And you're going to see a lot of these folks here, all 13 of these names highlighted in a ceremony that you've not seen before for obvious reasons. Okay. So stand by for that. I just want to make sure we got everything going on with the internet connection and things like that. And then we'll get started here soon. I'm going to wait for the thumbs up. We should be okay, but I want to get that confirmation and then we'll get started. But if you can hear me right now, and if you can see me right now, no need to go to the doctor to get a checkup. You are seeing me in person. This is live right now. And then we'll talk about some of the ceremony, which and it looks like I got the thumbs up. So that's great. See, this is why I get paid the big bucks. I can stretch. All right, here we go. So welcome everybody. Josh Shore with you. We are on the 14th floor live right now. Inside the mayor's office, which by the way, I like what he's done in the place. This sign is like stuck here. He can't move it now. So after this event is over, he won't be able to find me unless he finds me on the air tomorrow morning. Regardless, I'm so happy to be doing this third straight year of hosting this wonderful event where we get to highlight and show off and present to all of South Bend amazing people. And in the case of this year, 13 amazing folks will be honored. As they should be for what they've done, not just over the past year, which has been extremely difficult for several reasons, but just in general. I want to just let you guys know a few things. I have no teleprompter here. So forgive me if I say something wrong, if I screw something up. That's one thing. Secondly, we are on Zoom. We were supposed to start at 6. Now, I know in years past, I've made fun of everybody who comes into the Charles Black Center straggling in late and everything. And I always make fun of you guys saying y'all on CP time. By the way, if you don't know what CP time is, look it up. But CP time in today's case, computer problem, okay? That's what that stands for. So we may have some issues, knock on wood that we do not. I'm gonna knock on the mayor's desk since he's here. Anyways, we're glad you're with us and we're happy to be highlighting some amazing folks here for our 6th annual award ceremony. I wanna talk about how this time last year, we were all together, or at least some of us. We were all together, we were at the Charles Black Center. We honored some more folks last year, and we did it because we knew every year we've been doing this for the last 6 years now, we've been doing this because we know that there's a void sometimes in our city that we need to highlight, but not only highlight, celebrate those in our community. We need to talk about and put at the fore, for those of you watching tonight, you know what I'm talking about, to show people and inspire people and influence people through the people that make this city work, but not just the city. Some of the names here you've not heard just in South Bend. I'm going to give, for example, Nathan Boyd, Niele, Ivey, Carl Buchanon. South Bend names, but their names, they stretch far wider than that. They cast a wide net beyond South Bend, beyond St. Joseph County. And so that's why the names that you're going to see here, the people you're going to be seeing honored later on tonight, it's worth it, everybody. One thing I want to let you guys know, again, we're on a Zoom right now, but this is live. Although this is live, in just a few moments, you're going to be seeing a pre-recorded version of our festivities. So the pre-recorded version was done, and of course we adhered to protocols and what have you. Everything that we did, we had masks, we were socially distanced, so no worries, no questions, no concerns about that should be raised. But over the last few days, we've been working really hard to bring this to you. One of the things I want to let you guys know is that what you're about to see after I finish talking is a pre-recorded version. So that pre-recorded version, you're going to see Shay Davis momentarily with the city of South Bend. You're going to hear from her in just a moment as well. But I just want to mention, this time last year, Charles Black Center, there were no masks, right? We were not distanced. We were together, we were close, we were laughing. And little did we know that in about 2.5, 3 weeks time, we would be a part of a pandemic. Now for most of us, depending who's watching, this is our first pandemic. This is my first pandemic, at least. And I know how difficult of a time this is and can be for so many of you. But these 13 names right here, they never gave up. They continue to do what they do best, inspire a community, work to inspire people. They're not just talk, they actually do the things necessary that make our city work. So without further ado, we're going to get right to the ceremony and honor these folks. Here's what I do want to mention. At the very end of this broadcast, you're going to see some credits. After the credits, stay tuned. I'm going to have some closing remarks. Why? Because I like to talk. That's why they pay me. So we're going to have closing remarks from me. And then after that, we are going to end this thing. So this is going to last for about maybe 50 minutes or so. We hope that you got your popcorn. We really worked hard on this. We want to give a shout out to everybody who played a role in this presentation tonight. Now, without further ado, we want to give it to Shay Davis. She's the Director of Community Outreach for the Office of the Mayor. We want to give her a welcome, and we want to thank you guys for watching tonight's ceremonies.
Thank you, Joshua, for that warm introduction. Good evening, South Bend. I want to thank each one of you for joining in tonight for our 6th Annual Black History Month Award Ceremony. We have some amazing individuals that will be honored tonight. Unfortunately, this year, due to COVID-19, we weren't able to gather together at the Charles Black Community Center. However, we have a wonderful program in place for you to enjoy from the comforts of your home, and more importantly, so we all can remain safe. Black History Month is a month set aside to recognize, honor, and celebrate the achievements of African American men and women throughout history. I would personally like to congratulate all of this year's honorees for all their contributions. And again, thank you for being a part of tonight's experience. Now moving forward with the program, the next voice you will hear from is the amazing Makita Greer.
And I'll rise. That was awesome. That's Makita Greer, everybody. South Bend Zone, accompanied by Delshawn Taylor on the keys. We know that tandem is amazing. By the way, if you don't know, if you've never heard a rendition of Rise Up like that one, don't worry, because you're never going to again. That is purely golden right there. Those two together, they make magic. All right, before we get to tonight's festivities, we've got to talk about the honorees. With a tribute tonight for us, Kimberly Reeves.
Greetings. It is with excitement that I join many today in honoring you. Before I do so, I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Kimberly Greene Reeves. I am with Beacon Health System. I join Mayor James Mueller and the City of South Bend honoring Mr. Carl Buchanon, Dr. Okanlami, Cory Brazier, Darryl Heller, Harold Brazier, Murray Miller, Debra Walker, Karla Lee, Latorya Greene, Nathan Boyd, Shawn Henderson, Tyler Rouse, and Coach Niele Ivey. When I thought about one word that offers contribution, I thought about the word legacy. Oprah Winfrey states, "You have no idea what your legacy is. Your legacy is every life you have touched. Your legacy is every person you've met whose influence is felt by you." And for that, we say thank you. Thank you for the contributions that you have made. Thank you for working and living in your passion. Thank you for making a difference in the lives of many and for being pillars for the city. We are grateful for you. We wish you only the best. Take care and God bless.
Miss Kimberly Reeves, thank you so much for that. Those words of inspiration as we head into nice festivities. We really appreciate that. And thank you for mentioning Oprah too. I don't think we should have a night without mentioning her name. So we really appreciate that. All right, we are obviously outside of this beautiful Charles Black Senior Recreational Center. This is where we normally would have our event. We can't have that for obvious reasons. We are in a pandemic. Now granted, we are at the beginning of hopefully the end of this pandemic. Speaking of the beginning, the genesis of Mayor Mueller's term here in South Bend actually started with him taking the helm at the beginning of this pandemic. So he's had a lot to navigate, to say the least, but he's been doing so with your input, the community. Those of you watching tonight, he's done it with your help, and he's done a lot. He's burdened a lot as well, but he's had help through all this, including from Shay Davis, who's actually put this on. Shout out to her from the very beginning, 6 years ago. So coming up, we're about to hear from the mayor, and then we're going to go into tonight's honorees, and we're going to talk about all 13 of them at length as well. But we start off with the word from Mayor Mueller.
Well, thank you for those terrific performance and special tribute. And it's hard to believe that we're here in the sixth annual edition of this great event. And I want to send a special shout out to Shay Davis, who helped come up with this idea 6 years ago, as well as figuring out how to adapt this event to the current pandemic conditions. And the Charles Black Center here, it does feel a little empty without all of you here to celebrate with us, but we will be back together soon, sooner than later, hopefully, and definitely by next year's award presentation. And of course, this year's honorees will be hopefully be able to make it then too, and so we can actually fully celebrate together. And we have 13 wonderful honorees today, and we know many of them, and this is not a recognition of what they've done in the past, but also what they will continue to do for our community going forward. And for those of you that have not been honored yet, this is really a challenge to come work with us and help our community and build our community to be a better place for all of us. And so with that, we'll start with the honorees. And the first one is a familiar face around the community, Nathan Boyd.
Nathan Boyd, he took on a new role January of last year as principal of Navarre Middle School, part of South Bend's Empowerment Zone. As SBCSC's former chief equity officer and director of African American Student and Parent Services, he made what he called an easy decision to return to where he was most needed, children. Nathan has been in education now for over 20 years, 18 of which as an administrator in public schools. He is a 2012 ISCA Principal of the Year, 2012 National Blue Ribbon of School Excellence recipient, and 2016 Indiana State Principal of the Year. After all those accomplishments, after all those successes, he still measures his success by that of the children he serves. Ladies and gentlemen, Nathan Boyd.
I want to say thank you. This is an opportunity that I don't take lightly. I am humbled to be here. I'm humbled and honored to be standing next to such great individuals. You know, it's unique because the majority of the individuals that are being honored today, I've had the pleasure of working with or beside in some way, shape, or form. So it's just a special honor to be able to receive such an award right next to great people that work here in our wonderful community. The opportunity that I have every day working alongside children is one that gives me a unique opportunity to impact our children for years to come. On Mondays, I'm excited to be right next to our kids, whether it's virtual right now or in person in the hallways and classrooms. So I look forward to being able to continue to do this for many, many years to come. And I just want to say thank you for giving me the opportunity to do this work. It's something that I love. Thank you.
Our next honoree is Harold Brazier.
Harold Brazier was born and raised on the southeast side of South Bend in a large but close-knit family. He always had a passion for sports and competition and achieved much success in the field of professional boxing. He won several Indiana welterweight titles, such as the Northern American Boxing Federation, International Boxing Federation, as well as titles for the U.S. Boxing Association and Mid-American. As a South Bend native, he used boxing as a way to connect to and mentor the youth of his hometown. He has dedicated much of his time participating in charitable events for the community, including Notre Dame's Bengal Bouts, and mentoring and motivating the youth at the Boys and Girls Club and local schools. In 1994, man, such a good year, Harold was inducted to the South Bend Hall of Fame for his achievements in service within the community. He was also honored as a 2019 inductee of the Indiana Boxing Hall of Fame. Harold plans to continue serving his community while enjoying life with his wife, children, and grandchildren. Ladies and gentlemen, Harold Brazier.
All right, thank you. I'm thankful and pleased to be here today. I want to thank all the people that were before me. I know a lot of people had to die for us to get the right to do what we do today. I'm thankful and blessed for all the people that came before me. I feel blessed being in the community for things I've done, but to help my son follow my footsteps and do his thing is even a bigger honor for me. I'm thankful again for being able to be a part of this Black history, because I know the history of our people, what it took to get here. So I'm thankful, I appreciate it. God bless everybody.
Our next honoree is a familiar face in the city government itself, Chief Carl Buchanon.
Chief Carl R. Buchanon, say the whole name and the initial too. He is a lifelong South Bend resident, and he has been a firefighter now for more than 3 decades. And in 2020, just last year, he accepted the calling to become fire chief. Now, during his time with the department, he's gained specialization in fire prevention programs, training, planning and education workshops, CPR instruction, firefighting principles and practices, organizational management, and attended courses at the, I hope I'm saying this right, TEKS Fire Training School and National Fire Academy. He knows what I'm talking about. Chief Buchanon is a graduate of John Adams High School and former track and field coach there and at Clay High School for a combined total of nearly 20 years and has served as a mentor for students in the community. Ladies and gentlemen, Chief Buchanon.
Thank you, Mayor Mueller. As my comrade just stated, I am deeply humbled and honored as well to receive this award. on behalf of who I am and who I represent. None of us gets to wherever we are in life by ourselves, and I am no exception. My family, my friends, my comrades, everyone that have been alongside me and continue to keep me standing when I could have failed. I owe it to them, as I owe it to the citizens that I serve, to be a pillar of this community, to be an upstanding citizen, to always try to do right and defer others from doing wrong. I don't know where my journey will end, but I'm glad that it's surrounded by individuals such as these alongside of me that continue to serve our community, continue to stand up for what we believe in, and continue to show honor amongst our race. Thank you.
Our next honoree is Latorya Greene.
Latorya Greene is the Director of Community Health and Well-Being and Tobacco Initiatives with St. Joseph Health System, formerly St. Joseph Regional Medical Center. She's the Program Supervisor, Policy Coordinator for the Lead Agency Tobacco Control Coalition Smoke-Free St. Joe in St. Joseph County for tobacco education, prevention, and cessation. She received her Bachelor of Science in Health Science, minor in Public Health at Ball State University, and her Master of Business Administration, Healthcare Management at Indiana Wesleyan University. Latorya, also a local expert in HIV/AIDS education and prevention with 16 plus years of experience. She served on a number of advisory boards, including the South Bend Community School Corporation School Health Advisory Council, School City of Mishawaka School Health Council, Elkhart and St. Joseph County's Head Start Consortium Health Advisory Council, and is a founding member of the St. Joseph County Health Improvement Alliance. Ladies and gentlemen, Latorya Greene.
I'd like to thank the city for this great honor. I am truly humbled by this. I do know that any and everything that I do is because of the love that I have for this city. I've born and raised in South Bend. I actually grew up here on the lake, so it's so honored to be able to get this honor right here within the Charles Black Community Center. I'd like to thank and give glory and honor to my God, because without him, nothing is possible. It is truly through his anointing for the great work that I am able to do. But I definitely have to thank my family, my husband Lawrence, my beautiful daughter Legacy, as well as my mother and my mother-in-law, as well as all my family and my great co-workers and community members. I just thank you again for this great honor and hope to continue to be able to give you glory and honor and praise and make you all proud. Thank you so much.
Our next honoree is someone who's returned to our community, and we're excited that he's back working for all of us, Darryl Heller.
Darryl Heller is the director of the IU South Bend Civil Rights Heritage Center and an assistant professor of women's and gender studies. After receiving his BA in philosophy from the College of Charleston in the early 80s, he spent 20 years working in the fields of human services, community development, and political activism. Since arriving in South Bend in 2015, he's brought his extensive experience as an organizer and activist to the work of the CRHC, transforming it into a vibrant hub of activity in the fight for civil rights and social justice. He also teaches and facilitates discussions on the difficult topics of the history of racism and white supremacy, race construction, and the intersection of race and gender. He currently serves on the board of the Community Forum for Economic Justice and of Imani Unidad, and was recently appointed to the South Bend Board of Public Safety. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't speak Spanish, but I tried, Darryl Heller.
Like many of my other honorees, I'm very aware that this is a collective effort. So the award that I got today is really because of the work that so many other people are doing. And I particularly want to thank those who are working diligently to transform the institution of policing so that it protects and serves everyone. And for those who are working to strengthen and extend our public education system so that every child is deemed worthy and capable of learning. And for everyone who's working on restorative justice and transformative justice practices so that we can reorganize and redevelop the way that we build relationships in our community and that the dignity of everyone is a given. And so I thank the mayor, I thank all of those who are honored today, and I thank you for the work that you're doing. Thank you.
Our next honoree is Shawn Henderson.
Shawn Henderson is a 1998 grad of South Bend Riley High School. Since his graduation from high school, he went on to play college basketball at Ancilla College, where he found great success. After completing a year at the college, Shawn transferred to Lincoln Trail Community College, where he earned his associate's degree in May of 2000. He continued his academic and athletic career at Maryville College in Maryville, Tennessee. Shawn graduated from Maryville College in December of 2002 and returned home to South Bend, Indiana. Shawn began teaching at Washington High School in 2004, and soon after, he enrolled into Indiana University in South Bend and earned his master's degree in education. Shawn is currently in his fourth year as principal of South Bend Riley High School, where he graduated from in 1998, as we told you. Shawn has made a vow to serve the students in his community where he grew up, not to mention a vow to just stay in school his whole life. Shawn Henderson, you guys.
I just want to take this opportunity to say thank you. Thank you so much for this honor. You know, as a young man from the city of South Bend, I've had a lot of great models within my life. And watching them grow up and doing the things that they do. So this is a huge honor to be considered as someone that is a pillar in this community. I love my city. I love South Bend, and I want to continue to do the things that we can do to make South Bend better. So thank you all so much.
Our next honoree is Karla Lee.
All right, let me just add, as I introduce Miss Karla Lee here, that next year, whoever the winners are, whoever the recipients will be, they need to just put in three sentences as a bio, okay? Because I'm out of breath. I'm truly out of breath, but this is worth it. Miss Karla Lee is a school leader who knows the power of an equitable education. Her passion and dedication to public education on South Bend's West Side is visible to parents, but also students and the diverse community itself. As a principal of Harrison Elementary School with the Empowerment Zone, she approaches the needs of the community with passion, drive, and compassion. She's currently a member of the South Bend Alumni Association and South Bend, Washington Athletic Booster Club, where she served as president. Athletics is a strong part of who she is, by the way, in case you didn't know. She also participates in several other volunteer initiatives as a member of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, South Bend Alumni Chapter. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Karla Lee.
God is certainly interesting, and it's funny how what you want your story to be and how he has designed your story sometimes matches and sometimes it doesn't. Because who would have thought as a student in Harrison Elementary that I would return one day and be the principal? And I am just so eternally thankful that 630 some families trust me every day to be a leader for their children. And I don't take that responsibility lightly at all. However, I would be remiss in saying that I stand and do that work alone. Thankful for everyone that has come before me to allow me to every day, as one of my colleagues said earlier, every day, Monday through Friday, to get up and have fun doing what you do. And if you can say that every day, that is certainly a blessing indeed. So thank you to everyone. Congratulations to this class. And take care of yourself and take care of each other. Thank you.
Our next honoree is Murray Miller.
Murray Miller is currently the business manager, secretary, treasurer for the Labor International Union of North American Local 645. And in this role, he's a representative of the local union. It's his responsibility to ensure the affairs and business of the local union are being properly conducted. He's dedicated himself to serving and is currently serving the community in the following areas. President of St. Joseph Valley Trades, Indiana Laborers District Council Executive Board, Trustee Indiana Laborers Health and Welfare Fund, and Board of Directors Indiana Black Expo. Deep breath. All right, so Murray is the former head coach. He's a former head wrestling coach for Washington High School. His former service also includes the Indiana Wrestling Coaches Association, St. Joseph Valley Athlete Association, Washington High School Booster Club, Executive Board, and board member of the NAACP. The point of all this, Mr. Murray has a lot of time on his hands. Ladies and gentlemen, Murray Miller.
I'd like to thank whomever nominated me for this, the city of South Bend. thank God for allowing me to be able to do some of the things that I've been able to do here. And I'm a lifelong member, lived in South Bend all my life, and I just love it here. Thank you.
Our next honoree is Dr. Bunmi Okanlami.
Dr. Bunmi Okanlami, she's Nigerian by birth and American by choice, a physician leader who's board certified in pediatric critical care medicine and currently serves as bicentennial chair of palliative or palliative, I looked it up, it's both ways, palliative care in the Vera Z. Dwyer College of Health Sciences, University of Indiana, South Bend. She served as medical director of pediatric critical care and pediatric emergency medical transport services in South Bend, Indiana, for more than two decades, developing leadership and program building skills and advancing pediatric critical care services in Northern Indiana. She obtained an executive MBA from the Mendoza College of the University of Notre Dame, Indiana, in 2008. And she's co-founder and past president of A Rosy Place for Children, an innovative nonprofit organization serving the needs of medically fragile children and their families in both Indiana and Michigan. Dr. Bunmi Okanlami.
Thank you very much to the City of South Bend and the mayor and the nominating committee for nominating me for this Black History Month recognition. I live by the motto of blooming where I'm planted. South Bend is where I was planted about 27 years ago, having been born in Nigeria and coming here for graduate school. I was accepted in South Bend, and as a physician in South Bend, I did critical care, taking care of the most vulnerable children in South Bend, a job that was more than a job, but was really a calling. God did the work and I got paid. And currently I've pivoted and now I'm in the educational system at IUSB, living my life just asking every day how God can show me how I can be the answer to another person's prayer. I look at the list of people who have gone before receiving this award and I'm honored. Thank you for this.
Our next honoree is Debra Walker.
Debra Walker is a South Bend native and graduate of Washington High School. She received a bachelor's degree in social work from Ball State University as well. And she's held true to this and has been employed as outreach coordinator and match support specialist at Big Brothers and Big Sisters of St. Joseph County for the past, get this, 35 years. She has been very active in community affairs and is affiliated with numerous community service organizations. Don't believe me? Check this out. She's served on the board of directors for Martin Luther King Foundation of St. Joseph County since 1990, the board of directors of the South Bend Heritage Foundation since 2013, the South Bend County Merit Board since 2019, and oh, to be a Delta girl, she's been a member of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Alumni Chapter since 2000. Debra is married to Earl Walker Jr., and the proud mother of amazing kids, one son, Travis, and two stepsons, Dion and Earl III, and the grandmother of five. Look at her now. She's happy, but she's still nervous about that Washington Panthers game this weekend. Ladies and gentlemen, Debra Walker.
I would like to say thank you so much for this honor. I would like to also say that God is ahead of my life and has ordered my steps for many, many years and continues to do so. I've had the opportunity to have some wonderful mentors who came before me and helped me be able to do the things that I do. I grew up in this community. I'm not originally from South Bend, but this is my home. And I thank everybody for just giving me the opportunity to stand before you and to receive this honor. God bless you, and thank you so much to the City of South Bend and to the community that I serve, the West Side, the North Side, the South Side, the East Side, the entire city of South Bend, Indiana. God bless you.
This is your time. It's time for you to spread your wings and fly. This is your moment. Don't turn back now.
So now we're moving into other award categories, and we start with the Obama Award. And I don't know if there was a Brazier member on the committee, but we have another member of the Brazier family being honored here today. I'm kidding. We know that the awardee has certainly earned this award in the community. And the Obama Award for this year goes to Cory Brazier.
Cory Brazier is a co-director of Gentlemen and Scholars Incorporated, a nonprofit co-ed mentorship. And it's an organization based out of South Bend, Indiana. He's also the co-owner of Brazier Fit Boxing, a fitness company that was formed by modeling the techniques and fitness regimen of his father, former number one ranked boxer, Harold Brazier. He was born and raised in South Bend and has a mindset, Cory does, that is well aware of the current pulse of the community. Married with two kids, two awesome children, Corey's passions are along the lines of a strong family bond, holistic health and wellness, the finding of one's effortless purpose, and financial empowerment. Don't mess with him on the street, y'all. Cory Brazier.
When I think about the name Obama, as he's attached to this award, I think about temperance. This fella went through a lot when he was in politics and in leadership, and always admired his demeanor as he was uplifted and also attacked. As I move through the community and I'm able to share the message of fighting for your health with my dad and Brazier Fit and creating better versions of yourself with my partner Will and Gentlemen and Scholars, I think about how many things we have to go through in order to uplift our community. And just knowing that our steps are ordered, this encourages me to be as temperate. Thank you, South Bend, for allowing me to represent the Obama Award. I'm truly grateful.
Our next award is for Leader Under 40, and this is for being one of the most outstanding young leaders in our community. And the Leader Under 40 award this year goes to Tyler Rouse.
Tyler Rouse is a South Bend native, growing up on South Bend's northwest side. He graduated from Clay High School in 09 and continued on to Anderson University, where he studied criminal justice and communication. During his time there, he also learned to coach youth sports as a student coach for Anderson's football team. He's currently a part of the South Bend Empowerment Zone as a peace builder, and in this role, he and his team serve the families and students of the city's five West Side schools. He's also the founder of The Village, a local youth mentoring group that focuses on building strong skills and support for young boys of the community. Tyler served as the precinct vice chair for the 2nd District for several years and is currently involved with Indiana Young Democrats. He's a husband, father of three, a business owner, and a mentor to many youth that he comes in contact with throughout the South Bend community. Tyler Rouse, y'all.
Thank you to the mayor and to his nomination committee. I also want to say congratulations to fellow recipients, a lot of people who I've had the privilege of learning from. So that's quite an honor. I know I'm in good company here. I think about the families of the West Side and South Bend and the young people who are trying so hard to educate themselves and to be better and to change their input and output in life. And I'm inspired by their work, which challenges me to work even harder. And I'd like to leave you with this scripture here. And this scripture is 2 Chronicles, verse 7 and 14, and it says, "If my people who are called by my name humble themselves, pray and seek my face," this is God talking, "seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear them from heaven and heal the land, forgive their sins." I know I live in a place where some healing that needs to be done, and I appreciate my city for letting me be a part of that healing. So thank you to the mayor and to his nomination committee, and y'all have a good one. Thank you for coming.
And And our final award is a special tribute to none other than Coach Niele Ivey.
Niele Ivey became just the fourth Karen and Kevin Keyes family head women's basketball coach on April 22nd of last year, and the first black female head coach in the history of the University of Notre Dame. She has been the common link to all nine of the program's final four appearances, two as a player and seven as an assistant coach, spending a combined, 17 years on Notre Dame's campus before accepting the head coaching position. Ivy expanded her basketball prowess when she stepped away from Notre Dame to accept an assistant coaching position with the Memphis Grizzlies for the 2019-2020 season. She proved to be a true trailblazer as well, becoming the ninth active female coach in the league. Ivy helped develop a young team with the new coaching staff into a playoff contender while working with the likes of Ja Morant and Jerrion Jackson. As a player, Ivy donned the Irish uniform from 1996 to 2001, leading the program to its first national title in her hometown of St. Louis in 2001. In fact, she was the first Irish point guard to earn All-America honors. Now, after graduating, she went on to play five seasons in the WNBA, beginning with her selection by the Indiana Fever and later joining the Irish staff in 2007.
Proud of you guys, but we got two more. Let's go 4-0. Why not?
Together. The rest is history, and she's history. Ladies and gentlemen, Niele Ivey.
Thank you, Mayor Mueller, and thank you for the South Bend community for this incredible award. It's an honor to be a part of the 6th annual Black History Month Award. I'm hoping to continue to impact and inspire lives, not only in the Notre Dame community, but in the South Bend community. So thank you so much. Go Irish.
All right, before we end tonight, we're about to have a wonderful rendition of A Change Gonna Come from Jonathan J.D. Davis, a legend here in South Bend. He's going to be accompanied by Terrell O'Neill. I want to mention, though, we've got all 13 honorees tonight. We want to thank all of you for everything you've done in South Bend and really throughout all of Michiana. The work that you do, continue to do, even during a pandemic and through this pandemic, you are holding our hands as we walk through all of this together. So we want to thank you guys. When you hear names like Ivy and you hear Okanlami and you hear all these last names, we really want to thank you guys for not just what you do, but the inspiration that you bring all of us watching here tonight. You guys are really inspirational as we have aspirations past this pandemic, looking into a new future and looking to return to some semblance of normalcy. We look at all 13 of you and you know what? We say there's hope out there. So we want to thank you all again for that. And now for this awesome rendition, we want to go to Jonathan J.D. Davis. And as we said, accompanied by Terrell O'Neill.
I was born by the river in a little tent. Well, and just like river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know change gonna come. Oh yeah. It's been too hard living. I'm afraid to die, 'cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know change is gonna come, yeah. Oh well. That I go to my brother, and I say, brother, will you help me, please? All right. But he winds up knocking me right down on my knees. Oh, there's been times that I thought I wouldn't last for long. well. Now I think I'm able to carry on. It's been a long, long time to come in, but I know change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.
This is your time. It's time for you to spread your wings and fly. This is your moment. Don't turn back now. Just stay the course and fly beyond the clouds. We are here to celebrate you.
And that is the ceremony. It was interesting being able to watch that for the first time and not being a part of it with all of you, but we were still together, right? We were still a part of this thing together. I know during this pandemic, things have changed and the way of life has changed and shifted so dramatically in so many ways. But when you look at all 13 of these recipients, you realize that things don't have to stay stagnant. Even during a pandemic, even while people are losing their lives every day from this thing. We know a lot of you know someone who's lost their lives to this virus. But I think we're at the beginning of the very end. But one thing that doesn't change through all of this are stories of inspiration. And we saw it there with all 13 of these folks, South Bend native or not. They have impacted and changed so much in how we both interpret the city that we live in, but also how we can inspire as young adults and as those who are more mature, the generation that's coming up today. So much has changed in our world, not just due to the pandemic. We're hearing a lot about first Black. We heard first Black head coach for the Fighting Irish women's basketball team, right? We obviously have a first Black vice president, Madam Vice President. Doesn't that sound good? We're seeing this happen more and more. Because now people can see it. When people see it, they believe it. They know they can be it. And if they can be it, they do everything they can to achieve those goals. So that's what all of you guys who are watching right now have the propensity to do. Not just go out and do something, but going out and doing something and potentially impacting somebody else. So many people watching this. We got about 70 people watching on this Zoom. I know we got about 80 people watching on Facebooks around different Facebook pages. Inspire somebody today, tonight, tomorrow, next week. Through it all, we're going to get through this thing. I know this was different. We're not all together in person, but at the same time, we were able to master this in the best way possible. And I think, first off, to Shay Davis, hats off to you, because I know you started this 6 years ago. You never envisioned doing something like this. So we did this. And yes, hooray for us. I'm going to brag on us. We did it. I also want to give a shout out to Brian Frazier and Cory Pringle with Frazier Kid Productions, LLC. They did a phenomenal job of putting this together for each and every one of you watching tonight. We want to thank all of you all for watching as well. We want to thank all of our recipients who we honored tonight. And again, after tonight is over, when you lay your head on the pillow, you wake up tomorrow, wake up renewed and refreshed and inspired to change the world because you can. One person at a time. One community at a time. You can do it. If they haven't proven that tonight, I don't know who can. I'm Joshua Short. I will see you guys tomorrow morning if you wake up at 4:30, because I don't have a life. I got a job, I guess. So there's that. We will see you guys. Thank you guys for watching this Zoom or Facebook Live, wherever you're watching from. We're going to put this also on our YouTube page, by the way. And we're going to put this on our Facebook page so you can see it after it airs as well. But again, thank all of you guys who watched and commented or who raised your hands for no reason. We appreciate that too. Have a great night, everybody, and stay safe. Take care of yourself.